Bilash's explanation is good, and whatever the work he has done on that particular topic, gathering the information, diagrams, everything, it was superb. Okay, so we'll see here risk management. So first of all, what is risk? You have to understand, first of all, what is risk? Risk is nothing but like a problems or issues or bugs or whatever the issues has been raised in the different kind of areas, right? Not only on projects, whenever we are using any products, okay, whenever we are running any programs or whenever we are facing any difficulty, that is known as some risk. So whenever that risk has been arisen, we should have a capability to manage that risk, right? To management, we have to sort out that problem. Either we have to give a perfect solution, okay, or we have to do some commitments on that and we have to work on that particular, right? So if it is not possible with us, so that we are pushing into the checklist, so we are involving the experts and we are taking the help of the other persons, okay, like that, whoever has been faced that problem already, okay. So in that way, we are going to be taking some help and reduce that risk, right? So here, risk management. So what is this risk management actually? Okay, what is this risk management? So risk is nothing but a problem and we are going to be doing some changes and updating and trying to fix some issue. Okay, finally we can say. So here risk management needed some core competency, like helping the organization or delivering any product to the customer in that time. Okay, whenever that time has been exceeded, okay, unable to sort out that problem. At that time, here we are going to be consuming more time. That is also risk. Or whatever the estimation we have done, the cost estimation, if it is exceeded, that is also one type of a risk, right? If you won't get profit or loss, okay? Like that, these all things are going to be involved that. So here there will be some good risk management also requires, like better data and the information so that organization can take some action on that particular risk and they can sort out that all things. For that here, few teams will be there, for managing this all risk. They will be facilitating and they will be encouraging and capturing, doing the analysis, and finally they will be delivering that current and forward looking risk information. Means they are able to identify, okay, what kind of a risk is there, okay, doing the analysis and is there any solutions for that. Like that, they will be fixing some risk for that. So what is this risk management? First of all, what is this risk management? So risk management is the process of identifying, right, evaluating, assessing and controlling the threats to an organization, like capital and earnings, right? So whatever the problems has been arise, for that finding a solution. And what kind of a problem is that? What kind of issue is that? Okay, for that means with that, is there any effect to the organization or is there any effect on the project? Like that, they will be doing some analysis, right? So these threats or risk, whatever, could stem from a wide variety of sources, like financial uncertainty or legal liabilities and strategies. Okay, whatever the errors has been raised by this strategy management and accidents or natural disasters, right? So here risk management is nothing but just the process of doing like identification, evaluating and assessing and finding the problem solutions, right? So the risk management mainly means company will be, some few persons will be working on that, okay, like identification means company will be identifies and defines the potential risk that are may negative or they will, that will be effect for the project or for the company process. Okay, like that they will be doing some identification and risk analysis. They will be doing like a type of a risk, what type of a risk and how it will be affecting Okay, so what is its objective? Like that, they are doing some analysis on that, right? So here we are having some different types of risk, like generic risk management plan and project specific risk, right? So some people already we have discussed one example. There will be few human beings, okay? Whenever the problem has been arised, at that time we will see for that solution, okay? Why to waste time for now, from now onwards, okay? Like that, they will be thinking. Few people, okay, in future, whatever the problems has been arised, for that they will be finding the solutions and keeping, because in safe zones. So that they should not waste a time, they should not like do a more work on that, okay, like that. So here, generic risk management plan. So this generic risk management plan means it's a knowledge of general risk that would occur in particular project environment while implementing or doing any plan, right? At that time may risk arise. Okay, that means whenever we are working on particular project or implementing any planning, like that, at that time, if any risk arises, means we know that kind of a risk so that we can provide a solutions for that. And project-specific risk means here identified and managing the risk in that particular environment. Project means already in that particular project, we are working, right? If we are working, we know what kind of issues will be arise and what kind of a solutions should be there for that. So sometimes we don't know. Whenever the issues or anything happen, if we are perfect, then only we can provide a correct solution for that particular problem. If we don't know anything about that particular coding, then how can we provide a solution for that, right? So in this project specific risk, they will be identifying and managing the risk in that particular environment, or they will be taking the help of the domain experts or the managers they will be involving. And how to make a release commitment, ma? By using some weekly burn-up charts, they are doing some estimation and status of the work done, and they will be conducting some meetings, and according to that plan, they are doing the commitments and working on that, right? Success over schedule. So whenever they have done the plan, means definitely that plan should reach to the success. Okay, in that way they will be scheduling, right? So to complete the project in time. And results, what will be the results? With good risk management, you deliver on your commitments even in the face of disruptions. Whatever the, if you are able to find out that problem solution, then it's okay, and time consuming will be less, and you can according to the commitment, you can deliver that product to the customer. If it is taking much time, unable to sort out that particular problem, then you have to face some problems, right? So what are the contraindications? Use the risk management only for the external commitments. Okay, Abhi has been shown the checklist, for example, like how the issues are going to be raising, like internal, external products, okay, whatever. So mainly here, use the risk management only for the external commitments. Within the team, focus your efforts and completion of your project. So whenever we are working on any project, we will be focusing on the completion of project, right? So after completion of that, whatever the issues or anything has been arise, your testers and development team will be taking care of them, right? So after they are releasing that product, customer giving the feedback, with that also we can know what are the things has been done in that, right? And alternatives, what are the alternatives? Means risk management is primarily an organizational will be deciding, rather individual decision or team decisions will be okay or not okay. Like that, based on that they will be selecting the decisions, and if it is okay, they will be involving in that. Otherwise, they will be searching for the some other solutions, right? So here, risk management, it means mitigation. We have to sort a problem, or we have to find a solution for that particular and have to do some changes in that, okay? To do this all means whenever we are, I means risk containment and risk mitigations will be there. So So first, whenever the problem or risk has been arrived, means first we have to identify all the lists, make a checklist, okay, what kind of issues you have been arised. And next you do a plan, okay. First take the first issue and try to sort out, okay, if it is taking more time, next, okay, the person who knows, who will on that particular issue, he will be sharing his experience and knowledge, and entire team will be helping them to control that issues, right? So otherwise, if we are hiding that issues, okay, if we are hiding that issues and we are unable to share, that means it will be affect the project, and simultaneously team members also have to face a problems, right? So risk management is going to be including some task. Task means whenever the issue or risk has been raised, first of all, they have to identify the issue, okay, what kind of a issue is there and what kind of a solutions we have to find out for that. Means we have to find the risk and we have to trigger it, right? And what are the changes we need and what are the things we can do for that particular thing, okay? Like that, we have to do some thinking on that and identify and try to provide the solutions for that. Next, we have to classify and prioritize all the risk, okay? Make a list of all the risk and give the priorities, okay? 1, 2, 3 means if some 50 issues has been raised, right? Some you have sought some 20 issues and remaining whatever the 30 issues are there, okay, you are unable to sort out. So giving the priority to whom, like a team leader or some experience, they will be classifying and giving their type of solutions also. And next, you have to do a plan, okay, that should be linked to the risk and you have to get solution for that particular problem. Okay, how, in which way you have to plan, means whatever the problem has been arise, definitely you have to get some solution for that, right? And next, monitor for that risk triggers during the project. Whatever the risk has been happened, okay, you have to monitor the project, how the project is working, is there any issues, any problems, okay? Like that, monitorization is very important in that project. And implementing the mitigating actions if any risk materializes, means here whenever we are implementing, okay, now I fixed one problem, for this problem I am thinking this is a solution, okay, this is a solution I am thinking, but few people will be saying like I will show you. So whenever one problem has been arised like this, means here our problem is there, ma. So are you able to see my board, ma? Yes, everyone. Are you able to see? Okay, so here, how we are going to be sorting our problem means whenever the problem has been arised, okay, whenever the problem has been arised, here, first of all, we have to check the list. So here we are fixing our problem. Okay, this is my problem. So what I am doing means here, what kind of a problem is that? Okay, from 50, okay, I have sought some 20 problem solutions I have found. Okay, remaining 30, I'm unable to work on that. So what I am doing for this 30, I will be sharing in the checklist. Okay, I will be sharing these problems in the checklist. Here, everyone will be involving in that, like experts and developers. Everyone will be involving in that. So whenever one person selects one problem, okay, he is giving his type of solution, ma. Okay, this solution or this information is better for this type of a problem. Okay, this problem ki solution just a bond to me. And another person also involving and giving another solution to. Okay, so in this case, if we are getting many solutions, okay, solution one, solution two, solution 3. So they will be doing some analysis which consumes time less and cost less. Okay, then they will be selecting that type of a solution and they will be fixing in that particular problem. Okay, so ఏది perfect గా ఉంటుంది future లో, they should not face any problem again. Okay, so that type of a solution they are taking and they are taking it as a consideration and fixing into that problem. So like that here they will be changing their things, right? So how the problems are getting changes and how they will be changing, providing the solutions, right? So for every actions, okay, they will be providing and implementing and providing the solutions to the problems, whatever it has been arised, right? Next, communicate. Okay, communicate like they are doing some communication throughout the project, right? To avoid the risk, whatever the status is there, okay? Team is working for particular project. If they are getting issues, okay, they will be fixing on that, okay? How they will be fixing? Based on this communication, they are doing some discussions, conducting some meeting, okay? And asking the risk status, okay? How many issues you have sought out at? And how many solutions you have provided for that, okay? Like that, here they will be following some task, okay? Some task, identifying, classifying, planning, monitoring, and providing some mitigating actions on that, right? And communications will be there. And finally, and checklist, okay? Checklist means here all the best practices, whatever we have used, that all checklist will be there, okay? Some templates, if whatever the problem has been arised, okay, previously others also faced that same kind of a problem, but that already solution is there, means here we are going to be using some forward and thinking, and we are using that crisis in that, okay? And some checklist will be there, we can do some comparison to the previous projects, okay? And prioritize the risk, whatever the risks are there, how many risks, based on that we are dividing and we are going to be sorting out that problem. And develop some top 10 or 20 risk list from your project so that project managers can probably reuse and list on the next project. Okay, whatever the problems, whatever the issues you have faced on that particular problem, okay, so that you have to list out, and project managers, what they will be doing is they will be making it as a reuse and they will be working on that, right? And next here they will be watching, monitoring is very important, right? Meetings with the key stakeholders. And whenever the product has been released in the marketing, means how the customer is reacting and is where they're facing any risk or problem. Okay, like that they will be identifying and keeping some meetings to sort out that type of a problems also. And practicable, whenever the risk is large, here they will be splitting into a smaller and dividing into that, and they are going to be managing. Okay, for example, checklist lo 100 unnai ankonde risk, they will be dividing. Okay, first 10 you do, next 10 I will. Okay, like that they will be dividing and they will be working on that. And strongly they will be encouraging the stakeholders to think proactively and communicate about the risk through the entire project. Means they will be, whatever the issues or whatever the problems has been arise, they will be trying to fix and they will be sorting out that problem so that finally they have to deliver a bug-free product to the customers or the stakeholders, right? So like that, for that they will be doing some commitments, plannings, and they will be scheduling according to that, and they will be working according to that. So checklist will be like different kinds of checklist will be there. Right. So what is this generic risk management plan? So here generic risk management plan faces some set of common risk like turnover. Okay, turnover yearly, once the project has been completed, now how much, after 1 year, how much profit we can expect, okay, like that. New requirements, if any new requirements are coming in between of that project, then what will be the cost estimation we have to do. And some work disruption, if any problems or issues or anything has been arised, we have to fix and we have to work on that, right? So this risk acts as like a multiplier. like on your estimates, doubling or tripling the amount of time it takes to finish your work, right? So whenever they are giving one project, definitely you are doing some planning, ma. According to that plan, okay, we can complete that project into 90 days or some 100 days or 3 months. Okay, like that you are doing estimation. Okay, whenever the problems or issues are coming, okay, it is consuming more time. So like that means whenever the issues or risk are going to be tripling or doubling, it consumes much time to finish your work. So how much of multipliers depends on organizations. Okay, organizations have a database and type they are going to be completing before the various risk multipliers has been arised. Okay, they will be maintaining some solutions for that, templates, okay, like that, and fixing the solutions for that, how many members can involve in that. Okay, like that, they will be sorting out, trying to sort out all the risks. And this multiplier should show the chances of meeting various schedules, like whatever the what kind of a risk or approach has been there. Okay, 10% chance of finishing according to estimate solution, and doubling the estimates give 50% chance on time completion to be virtually of the meeting schedule estimates. Means here they are fixing one time. Okay, so in total 100% project, okay, some 10% is there, okay, 10% is there, and some 20% issues are there. Okay, how to work on that? So these all calculations will be depend upon that timing, when we have to deliver that particular product, and how many risk has been arised in that, how many issues has been arised in that, and how many members are involving in that. Okay, based on these all things, here we are doing some scheduling and conducting some meeting and trying to sort out that problems. Right. So generic risk management plan means here we are doing some plan to complete our project. Finally, project complete cheyadaniki oka plan vesukuntam munde. A plan kalla time kalla project aipoyinda manchidi. Okay, ledhu inka time extend avutundi ante, is there any issues or risk? Okay, how much time it will be consuming? Will we be able to provide a solutions for that or not? Okay, like that means generic risk means already known issues will be there, means we can already sort out. Okay, we can sort out and we can provide the solutions for that. And what is this project specific risk means? Whenever we are working any particular projects, okay, we are doing any execution of project, at that time we are doing some assessment of that particular requirement. Is that requirement is suitable or not? If we are buying any product from the electronic device, you have purchased one product, they will be giving some period of time like guarantee and warranty. Okay, for this motor, okay, for this motor they will be giving the guarantee for 2 years. After that, okay, you may face some problems. Like that, here they will be giving some specific risk will be there, means whenever you means this all estimations will be done before only assessment of that particular requirement. If it is good only, then they will be including in that, right? So a good starting place to identify the treats is milestones of the project. Okay, milestones. So whatever the project we are working, okay, if we are working that particular project for the 90 days, okay, we are working for the project and we are trying to complete that project within 90 days, and that project will be working for the 10 years. Okay, we don't know what kind of issues will be happen, what is in future, what problems has been created. Okay, so like that, for that also we have to do some assessment, risk assessment have to be done. Means whatever the 90 days work is there, we have to compare for the 10 years working, right? 10 years working. Like that, whenever the products, washing machine or TV or anything, there will be some estimation. They are doing that, preparing that project within days, and they have to give the estimation for how many years it will be work. రైట్ సో మీరు అందరు అబ్జర్వ్ చేసే ఉంటారు ప్రోడక్ట్స్ కొన్నప్పుడు రైట్ సో లైక్ దట్ అండ్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఇస్ హియర్ టు క్రియేట్ సమ్ పొటెన్షియల్ రిస్క్ అండ్ దే హ్యావ్ టు అడ్రస్ దట్ అండ్ అకార్డింగ్ టు దట్ దే హ్యావ్ టు ప్లాన్ ద ప్రాజెక్ట్స్ రైట్ సో అలాంటి ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ రాకుండా దే హ్యావ్ టు సీ దిస్ ఆల్ things right so whatever the some mitigations will be there different kinds of mitigation some transition indicators will be there and mitigation activities and contingency activities will be there risk exposures okay so these all are the different activities which will be raised in this to handle and to decide or to determine what kind of a risk it is right so ట్రాన్స్పరెంట్ గా ఉంటాయి సో దట్ వీ క్యాన్ ఫైండ్ ద సొల్యూషన్స్ ఫర్ దాట్ ఓకే కొన్ని మిటిగేషన్స్ ఎలా ఉంటాయి అంటే వీ కెన్ రెడ్యూస్ సమ్ రిస్క్ అండ్ వీ క్యాన్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద రిస్క్ ఆర్ అన్సాల్వ్ ఓకే వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఆర్ అన్సాల్వ్ సో వీ హ్యావ్ టు కలెక్ట్ సమ్ యూజర్ స్టోరీస్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు కలెక్ట్ ద న్యూ డేటా అండ్ న్యూ థింగ్ అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు మేక్ సమ్ న్యూ రిలీజ్ ప్లాన్ అకార్డింగ్ టు దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఇన్క్లూడ్ దీస్ ఆల్ థింగ్స్ మా లైక్ యూజర్ స్టోరీస్ అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు సపోర్ట్ దట్ అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు ప్రిపేర్ ద లోడ్ బ్యాలెన్సర్ అండ్ we have finally we have to avoid that risk right so like that here's different kinds of activities they have shown right so already these all things has been explained by this Abhi okay so how to make the release commitment means one point I need to explain time box okay start with your time box is nothing but like you are fixing one time whenever you are working on one particular project you are fixing one time or schedule within these 3 months okay we have to complete the project we are doing some commitment for that okay we, means forcibly all the team members and organization here they are involving in that they have to complete that all project within that time limited and they have to release that date and they for that they will be making some plan right so how they will be releasing and how the success over the schedule will be there and what is the commitment whatever the commitments whatever the requirements they have involved in that is it good or not okay like that these all estimations can be done so like that these all estimations can be done so in this way they are going to be sorting out the problems and finding the solutions for a particular